everybody, welcome to this second video about the basics of lung ultrasound. Today we will speak about the pleural line.
The pleural line is the reference, the starting point of lung ultrasound. It is the first structure we should look for before moving on to further evaluations.
And we should look for the so-called lung sliding. What is it, Luna?
The lung sliding is a horizontal sliding movement synchronized with respiration that occurs between the parietal and visceral pleural layers.
This is how lung sliding looks like in a convex probe.
And this is with a linear probe.
And this is with a cardiac sector probe.
The lung sliding can be also abolished, as in this example. So, you don't see the pleural sliding against the chest wall that is visualized above.
Well, what is the meaning of an abolished lung sliding, Luna?
Well, in one intuitive and simple definition, it is a sign of abolished ventilation of the lung. But not only. It may be also due to the fact that air in the pleural space creates a barrier and does not allow visualization of the visceral pleura.
Well, but this is pneumothorax.
Yes, an abolished lung sliding can have different causes, and pneumothorax is one of them.
Of course, and other causes can be, for instance, exclusion of the left lung in main stem intubation, and...
Oh, stop one moment, Giovanni. Do you mean that lung sliding can be visualized also in artificial ventilation?
Of course, Luna. I told you that lung ultrasound is not so clever. It doesn't differentiate spontaneous, induced, or even artificial mechanical ventilation. In respiratory arrest, the lung sliding disappears and then appears again when we correctly intubate and ventilate the patient.
And other conditions where the lung sliding is not visible are pleural adherences, but also when the lung is too stiff to be moved by respiratory movements, such as in consolidations of different etiologies or in ARDS.
So, to summarize, the lung sliding is the relative movement of the pleural line against the chest wall.
The lung sliding can be abolished, for example, in pneumothorax, but also mainstem intubation, pleural adherences, cardiac arrest, and regional stiffness.
Yes. It is very interesting. I already imagine the great potential of this sign in the daily practice for the bedside evaluation of our patients.
That's how it is.
We hope you enjoyed this video and more will follow. Thank you for being with us.
Bye-bye.